Hey, this is Gabriel.
This is Vicente from SoCalTint Motorsports.
And today we're going to be talking about the five important things that you need to know before you PPF your car. So first off, what is PPF? PPF is a clear, transparent film that is going to be going on top of the car's surface in order to enhance the paint and also protect it against rock chips, road debris, scratches, water spots, tree sap, a whole bunch of stuff. And the main purpose is to basically preserve the vehicle in its best state, which is gonna be when it's brand new. Film is gonna last nearly 10 years, so really is a good investment if you're looking to preserve the vehicle's finish and just keep the car looking brand new in general.
So you're now maybe asking yourself, what do we look for in the shop in order to determine if they could install PPF for us? The three things we recommend you check for is for their reviews, how their work is on PPF, and their overall quality of the cars they work on throughout their website, social media, or based off personal word of mouth. The next question we commonly get is, what is the difference between paint protection film and ceramic coating? So the easiest way to put it would be that paint protection film is more of a physical damage that you could prevent on your vehicle's paint. Meanwhile, ceramic coating is more of a durable protection for a lifespan of 4 to 8 years, depending on the coating you choose. So like I mentioned before, PPF is more physical damage, such as something scratching your paint, basically any little dings, hinges all over your front bumper due to rock chips. And ceramic coating is more keeping a clean surface due to its sleek finish it leaves on the vehicle's paint itself, and due to the water debeading technology that is included in the ceramic coating compound itself. All right, but Gabriel, besides of what I said, what do you think is the main difference between PPF and ceramic coating?
Yeah, so the main difference is gonna be that paint protection film is gonna be a film and ceramic coating is a liquid that dries on top of the surface, very similar to wax, although it's gonna last longer, about 4 to 8 years or more, depending on what kind of coating you get. And the paint protection film is gonna be a film that's applied on top of the surface, which could either be clear, colored. The other difference between PPF and ceramic coating is PPF is gonna be more durable against physical damage like rock chips, scratches, and road debris, while ceramic coating is more for the finish of the car, for like water spots, bird droppings, tree sap, the glossiness of the car, and how easy it is to wipe. So it's not gonna protect against scratches, rock chips, road debris, any kind of physical damage. So that's where basically the line would be drawn, is physical damage and not.
All right, so now that you went over the differences, would you recommend people getting both, or should they just go pick one?
Yeah, a lot of our clients go with both just because they complement each other very well, since the paint protection film is gonna help more with physical damage like rock chips, scratches, and all that. And if you combine it with the ceramic coating, it's gonna elevate the paint and the entire car a lot more, because it's gonna look glossier and the film is gonna be a lot easier to maintain also. So they go hand in hand together. And if you have a really expensive car or just a brand new car that you've worked hard to buy, it's a really good investment in order to protect and preserve that car's finish and also keep the value of the car up as well. Yeah, so customers ask us, how long does it usually take for the car to be protected also?
All right, and for that, it all depends on the package that you guys get. So depending if it's just the front portion, such as the bumper or a full front PPF, it ranges from 1 to 3 days. Now, if you want the full body, that'll take from a minimum of 5 days to a week. It all depends on the difficulty of the vehicle itself.
Yeah, and another thing that adds to how long the process takes is gonna be the size of the vehicle and the complexity of the shapes of the panels too. So it could vary a lot just depending how crazy the car is or how simple it is.
All right, Gabriel, usually when someone has PPF installed, they remove it over time. What do you think about that? Does it damage the paint once you remove the PPF?
So the film is designed to be on the car for up to 10 years. And as long as you protect the car when it has the factory paint on there straight from the dealership, then it'll be fine to rip that film off after those 10 years. But when you do have aftermarket paint, like if you've been in an accident and it's been resprayed, depending on the paint job quality, after the film has been on there for a few years or even sooner, depending on the paint job, it can rip off. So just keep that in mind. That's why it's very important to protect the car as soon as you buy it.
All right, another question we have, bro, is does PPF usually damage the paint when we remove it? What do you think about that?
Yeah, so PPF will not damage the paint once it's removed, as long as your car has the factory paint. If your car has been resprayed, then you do have a 50-50 chance of the paint coming off when you remove the film, but that's all gonna depend on the quality of the paint job and how they cure it and the entire process. So on the painting side, nothing to do with the performance of the film. It's not covered under warranty if the film does rip off the paint, just because that's gonna be a defect with the paint and not the film itself. So you will have to pay for that again for the car to be resprayed and then protected with the film again.
Hey Gabriel, what's a tip to know if it's original paint or repainted paint?
So one thing that is a telltale sign is if you notice like an orange peel type of finish on the surface of the paint, it'll be kind of like rough and bumpy. That's the number one way to tell. Also, if you see like overspray on other parts of the panel or like even inside the car, like door jams and stuff like that, it's best to have the shop that's installing the PPF inspect the car. And if they have that procedure, then that you know you're going to a good shop and they're gonna, you know, treat you well and make sure your car comes out right.
Before we move on to the last and most important question, if you guys are ever in need of window tinting, ceramic coating, paint protection film, or even vinyl wrap, visit us at our Rancho and Upland location, SoCalTint Motorsports, aka SCT Motorsports. Call, visit our website, message us on Instagram, SoCalTint1, and we'll be more happy to take care of you.
And lastly, the most important question is how much does PPF cost? So it'll range depending on how much protection you're looking for the car and what shop you go to, but it could range anywhere from $1,800 all the way up to $10,000 maybe. Like I said, it depends on the car, the color that you're going with, and the shop that you're going to.
All right, bro, what about those shops that are charging like $800 to $2,000 to do a full body PPF? What do you think about that?
Yeah, you wanna stay far, far away from those because you're gonna wanna question the quality of the film, the quality of the work, and ultimately, you know, the durability of all that, because it's expensive to be cheap, and you know, you're usually gonna have to spend more money to fix it. So stay away from those. If you guys are looking for any further information, you can visit our website, SoCalTintCA.com, and you can reach out on Instagram at SoCalTint1, and we'll be happy to help you and answer any questions you may have. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this.